Hi, and welcome to Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Here is your host, Dr. and Evangelist K.L. Rich.
Hi, and thanks for tuning in today. This is Dr. K.L. Rich with Narc Abuse No More, helping you to admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Yes, they do. But before we go on with today's podcast, I'd like to invite you to visit us on our website at www.narcabusenomore.org. Again, that website address is www.narcabusenomore.org. And on our website, you can find valuable information regarding narcissism, relationships, and if you have missed any of these podcasts, all you have to do is go directly to our website and listen to us from there. Now, just to let you know, we are on every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 9 a.m. Central, and that is on SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Spreaker, Google Play, iTunes, CastBox, and Deezer. We're also on Amazon Audible, Rumble, Brighteon, and The Tube. That's why we're on YouTube. So you have a variety of different platforms to listen to us from. But if all else fails, all you have to do is go directly to our website and listen to us from there at www.narcabusenomore.org. Also, just to let you know, for the new year, we're going to have another podcast that we're going to be airing. It's called Veterans in Christ. And so that podcast is going to be dealing with the spiritual aspect of being a veteran, as well as helping you to know what the different benefits that you are entitled to. So many veterans don't know what they're entitled to, and others are having a hard time getting those benefits that they are entitled to. So we're going to be talking about those things. We're going to be talking about CNP exams. We're going to talk about disability benefits, burial benefits, benefits that may be able to be transferred to your children, GI Bill, and more. We're also going to talk about when it comes to different mental health subjects, as today we're talking about PTSD and PTSD. We're going to be dealing with a variety of things, even for active duty. And we're going to give you the latest news that you can use as it pertains to military life. So if there's a draft, what to expect. So we're going to be talking about a variety of different things on that podcast. Again, that's going to be that podcast is going to air in January, the first Tuesday in January, every Thursday at 5 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, 4 p.m. Central. And again, it will be on SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, Spotify, Spreaker, Google Play, iTunes, CastBox, and Deezer. Also on Amazon Audible, Rumble, Brighteon, and The Tube. So we will have it on YouTube as well. I'm excited to get started with that in the new year, and I pray that you will share it with other people. Speaking of share, take a moment right now and please hit the share button on your favorite site that you listen to us from. Share it on your on LinkedIn. Share it on your Facebook page, your Twitter account, Gather, different platforms that you may have, so others may be able to get this valuable information that you are getting as well. Again, we're on every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday at 10 a.m. Eastern Standard Time, 9 a.m. Central, or you can listen to us at the time of your choice after the podcast airs if you are unable to tune in at that time. All right, so what are we talking about today? We are talking about 15 symptoms of PTSD from narcissistic abuse. We also, there's also PNSD, PNSD, which is post-narcissistic stress syndrome, very similar to PTSD. And this is a type of post-traumatic stress disorder, PTSD, that comes after a person has been in a relationship with someone who has narcissistic personality disorder. The symptoms are very, very similar to those who are dealing with PTSD. So again, this you can either call it PNSD, post-narcissistic stress syndrome, or PTSD, post-traumatic post-traumatic stress syndrome. The symptoms are very similar. Talking of those who have experienced this from a narcissistic abuser or any traumatic experience that may have taken place in your life. Many people ask themselves the question, how could I have let this happen? Or what's wrong with me? Or I feel dumb about this. Or why didn't I see this? Many of us have been blinded by those who are narcissists. Okay. So do not beat yourself up thinking that, oh, well, it's never going to change. Things are never going to happen for me. I messed up. We all made mistakes in life. Okay. We may have chosen to date the wrong person. Some people have married the wrong person. Some people have gotten the wrong type of job where they had a narcissistic boss or narcissistic co-workers. But the thing is, once you are aware of it, then you can change your situation. Okay, you are not alone. And the feelings you have about it is 100% normal. Okay, it's completely normal. But once you are aware of it, then you can do something about it. As always, I'd love to get your website where you can get this valuable information, and you can get it at unmaskingthenarc.com, unmaskingthenarc.com. And today we're talking about 15 symptoms of PTSD from narcissistic abuse. And there's a lot of events that can cause PTSD, rather it's a war. Many soldiers have gone to war, seen some horrific things. Okay, this week, what just took place in Israel, the terrorist organization Hamas and different ones that went into their country and did horrific things to the people there, that can cause someone to have PTSD. Okay, so I want to keep my prayers with them in Israel. And the thing is, war is something that is horrible. Many people might think it's lightly because think lighter because you might see a movie on television, but we just, even when we see things on television, it doesn't, it's a total different story when you're actually in the moment. All right. If it's a terrorist attack, something that happens and you were caught off guard, can cause you to have PTSD. If you deal with the death, many people have lost loved ones all of a sudden, or you may have been right near that person that died, and you wonder why wasn't it me? You know, why did they have to die? Why wasn't it me? Okay, so death can bring on PTSD. Natural disasters, people who have been caught maybe in a hurricane or earthquake or tornado, they may get PTSD because of that unexpected, or even if they knew it was coming, but they didn't think it was going to come to them. And then those who have been sexually traumatized, such as rape, molestation, and different things, can cause one to have PTSD. So you may have witnessed the event yourself, or you may have witnesses, you may have experienced it, because even if you may not have, the situation may not have happened particularly maybe to you, you may have been witness to it or whatever. So then it can cause you to have all different types of emotions. Now, complex post-traumatic stress disorder, or CPTSD, that's a condition that occurs after repeated trauma, such as abuse, such as domestic violence. Many people are dealing with complex PTSD. Some examples of that can be, again, domestic violence. It could be someone being kidnapped, as such as happened with those in Israel, kidnapped, tortured. You may have been a prisoner of war. Many people that have maybe gone in certain military, those that were maybe in the World War II or different ones, they may have had it or have known someone who had PTSD because they were a prisoner of war. Some people get this complex PTSD by childhood abuse and neglect that may have taken place, something that took place at an early age that that caused you to experience the type of PTSD. There's a variety of different triggers that often happen with those who are experiencing PTSD, where you can be doing fine and then all of a sudden something triggers you. For example, around the 4th of July or even the New Year, some soldiers are not able to be around the fireworks because it takes them back to when they were in the battlefield. So therefore, hearing all these fireworks and firecrackers and all these things, that you might see one immediately jump to the floor and get down low because they're going back to when they was in the field. And let me just say this, if you or someone you know is suffering from PTSD or PNSD, you do not have to be ashamed. You do not have to be worried about what others will say. There are a lot of people who are dealing with this. And so, they are in the fight or flight mode. But the thing is, you do not have to be afraid or feel embarrassed because you may be dealing with this. The thing is that whenever something happens to you in life, the best thing to do is to be head on, or should I say proactive with it, and get a handle on it and talk to those who may be able to help you in order to get you back on the right path, in order to be able to be that productive citizen in life, to be the best person that God would have you to be. So we want to always make sure that you get the help that you need. And my first thing we'll tell you to do is to pray and ask God to help you, and then go to those whom God will have to help you to get over, or should I say not get over, but to navigate through the situation that you may be dealing with. Now, I want to mention a couple of symptoms from PTSD or PNSD from narcissistic abuse. And these things may have you feeling as if you cannot move forward. You may feel frozen. You may feel like I'm not able to navigate life. And again, if you're having any of these symptoms that we're going to talk about, then you can definitely get the help that you need by talking to someone who is qualified to help you to get out of that situation. Talk to someone, even if they're not maybe medically qualified, but someone who understands you and someone who would be there for you in order to help you to navigate the PTSD or the PNSD that you're having. You may see some of these symptoms that we're talking about, you may be experiencing, you have to go to a licensed therapist for you that can let you know if this is what you have. And if you do, you can tell them that you suspect. And if you do have this, they can be the ones to help you. Now, I want to read this before we get into that. I want to read this narcissistic prayer that is posted. And this is how narcissists actually act and what they feel. They say, "That didn't happen. And if it did, it wasn't that bad. And if it was, that's not a big deal. And if it is, that's not my fault. And if it was, I didn't mean it. And if I did, you deserved it." That's the narcissistic prayer. And basically what this is, denial. It didn't happen. If it did, it wasn't as bad as you're making it out to be. So they will diminish your feelings. And if it was, that's not a big deal. So they will make you feel like you're making a big deal out of nothing. And if it is, that's not my fault, because of course they will never take responsibility for their actions. And if it was, I didn't mean it, because of course they're not going to allow you to blame them for anything, even if they were responsible for it, because they're going to make it seem as if, oh, you're not forgiving. You're not the one that's, you're the one that's making too much of a situation that was really not about anything. And then they say, if I did, you deserve it, because after all, they're going to make you feel as if you're the cause of their bad behavior, because of course they're never going to take responsibility really are blame themselves for the things that they do. So therefore, they're going to make you feel as if you deserved it and you're such an evil person and you're such a bad person that after all, their bad behavior onto you was warranted because of who you are, not because of what they did. That is the narcissist prayer. And everything about a narcissist, you have to understand, is that that's a weakness within them. It's not you. It is the narcissist. So number one, one of the common symptoms of PTSD or PNSD from narcissistic abuse is you feel stuck. You feel stuck. You feel confused. You feel like you're not able to maybe be in a healthy relationship. You feel like you maybe can't even get out of this relationship, or you feel like you can't move forward. You don't even know what to do, and therefore you feel like I'm in this situation and I don't know how to get out of it because the narcissist has made you feel as if you cannot do anything without them, or even if you try, it's never right because everything that you do for the narcissist is never good enough. So you feel stuck. Number two, you have hypersensitivity. Come on now. You have these extreme sensitivities that can be off the charts. Your nervous system is fried. So one minute you're calm, the next minute you're in fight or flight mode. You're being manipulated. You're being gaslighted by the narcissist. You're experiencing anxiety, panic, worry. You might feel overwhelmed. You may not feel safe. You may be obsessive about things. These are common symptoms of hypersensitivity that you may be experiencing because of the abuse of the narcissist. Because after all, what the narcissist loves to do is to have you feeling like you're in whiplash. You never know what side of the fence they're going to be on any given day. You never know what bag they're going to come out of on any given day. So you're always on guard, which messes with you all over, mentally, physically, and even spiritually. Another common sign of PNSD or PTSD is flashbacks. You may have flashbacks of the abuse that you went through. You may have a memory that pop out of nowhere. You could be just fine, and all of a sudden, some smell may take you back to something that happened. Some sound may take you back to what happened. Certain words may take you back to what happened. So you wind up reliving the event over and over and over again. It's like a moving marathon that is in your head, and you're not understanding what is causing this, and so therefore you may retell the story to someone and they might think you might be a little off or whatever, but it's your reality. So having those flashbacks, nightmares, you go to sleep at night and you might not be able to really sleep at night because you're having these nightmares of when something happened to you, and you may be reliving this through your dreams at night. And so therefore, even though the situation may be over, even though the situation may be done with, you may have left the person, you may have left the job, you may not be up under the roof of the parent or whatever the case may be, but you may be having those flashbacks or those nightmares in your dreams. And so though you want to carry on and be a normal individual by, living your normal life, these are setting you back, these flashbacks, these nightmares that you are experiencing. We're going to take a quick break and we'll be back in just a moment.
Another day has gone, I'm still all alone. How could this be? You're not here with me. You never said goodbye. Someone tell me why. Did you have to go? Something whispers in my ear and says,
And that is You Are Not Alone by Michael Jackson. And you are not alone. I want to give you the information to the National Domestic Violence Hotline. And you can go to their website at www.thehotline.org, www.thehotline.org. You can also call 1-800-799-SAFE. That's 1-800-799-7233. TTY callers can call 1-800-787-3224. You can also text the word START to 88788. Again, text the word START to 88788. You are not alone. And if you're going through any type of abuse, you can contact the National Domestic Violence Hotline or go to your local authorities or talk to someone you trust who can help you to get help you to safety or to get help as safely as possible. Also, if you are a veteran and you are in need of mental health services, call 1-800-827-1000. That's 1-800-827-1000. All right, so when we're talking about the common symptoms of PTSD when it comes to narcissistic abuse or PNSD, one of the common symptoms is self-blame. The narcissist blame themselves for the abuse, or they may be blamed by the narcissist for what the narcissist has done. Now, we often talk about narcissists do not like to take responsibility for their actions. Narcissists, they lack empathy. They oftentimes try to intentionally hurt other people, and they wear a facade. So when you may say or tell someone, well, this person is a narcissist, and they would say, no, they're not. They can't possibly be a narcissist. They're so nice. They're so kind. They're so self-sacrificing. And the thing is, narcissists fool people. Oftentimes, narcissists, now you have those that are pretty much obvious, but then you have those passive-aggressive narcissists that you will actually not be able to hardly tell that they are a narcissist unless you are the target of their abuse. So therefore, what the person is seeing on the outside is not what's being displayed at home. We talk about the Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde narcissist, where everyone sees the great Dr. Jekyll. He is the one that's respected in the community, and people bring their children and themselves to him because he treats them and cares for their wounds or whatever happens, their illnesses or whatever. And he's well established, and so therefore this is the outward image that people are seeing. However, behind closed doors, little do they know that he walks into Mr. Hyde. Okay, he's the evil, narcissistic, selfish person that kills in the middle of the night. If you've ever seen the movie or read the book of Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde, you will see that these are the same person, but two different individuals when it comes to their personalities. In a day, you see Dr. Jekyll. At night, Mr. Hyde is committing the most horrific crimes. And so therefore, when you're dealing with a narcissist, they will blame you, or you internalize it and start blaming yourself, thinking that you are the reason that this person abused you, and it's your fault that this person did all those nasty little things to you, when in actuality, that person is responsible for the things that they do themselves. You were just the recipient of their abuse. A narcissist will never feel as if anything is their fault. They will never take responsibility. They will always blame someone else. And then you, as the victim, internalize that blame and start blaming yourself, believing the lies of the narcissist. Another common symptom of PNSD, post-narcissistic stress syndrome, or PTSD, when you're talking about narcissistic abuse, is low self-esteem and low sense of self-worth. Have you felt as if you are just this person that is not worthy of love? You feel shame, you feel guilt, you feel as if you're not good enough, and you believe these things. You feel as if you're useless. That's what the narcissist wants their victims to feel, as if you can never be at their level, that you will always have to have their input. You start losing a sense of yourself, your own identity, and so therefore narcissists are masters at eroding someone's self-esteem, so someone's sense of self-worth, and they will chip away at it until you actually don't have any part of your true self left, because they have killed whatever inspiration or whatever confidence you had in yourself. You will lose it by dealing with a narcissist. Another, when it comes to sign of having dealt with PNSD or PTSD, is you deal with erratic emotions. One minute you feel like you're on a high, and the next minute you feel like you're on a low. And so therefore you may experience, bouts of anger or sadness or grief. Sometimes you may be happy. Sometimes you may be very sad. And I'm not talking about when you're dealing with hormones or menopause. I'm talking about when you're dealing with the trauma that you have experienced by being in an abusive narcissistic relationship. And so therefore your emotions are all around the place. Sometimes you may be quick to get angry. And the thing is, if you're experiencing these type of emotions, it is best to talk to someone who can help you navigate through them. Another thing is you may numb out. You may you may do this as a protective measure to minimize what you have gone through or the panic that you're experiencing. So basically, you may disassociate from your thoughts, your feelings, your sense of self, because you're trying to compartmentalize those feelings that you're having. So therefore you may be one that turn to drugs and alcohol. You may be shopping. You may have a shopping addiction or food addiction or gaming addiction, because you're, instead of dealing with the problem directly, you use other outlets in order to, and I'm talking about unhealthy outlets to try to diminish or try to medicate the pain that you're really experiencing from the PTSD. One thing that is often a result of the PTSD or PNSD is you have problems with trusting people. You have trouble with trusting people. So you may avoid relationships altogether because you do not trust anyone you would think that some people will hurt you or all people will hurt you. Therefore, you feel like I can't trust myself and therefore I can't trust anyone. These are things that you can talk to someone, because everyone is not going to hurt you. But as the Bible says, be wise as a serpent and harmless as a dove. That means that you are wise enough to know everything that's going on around you. And at the same time, you're not causing harm or allowing someone else to cause harm to you. You need that, what we call as Christians, spiritual discernment, to know who you can trust, who you can, who you should be around, who you should not, what situations to be involved in and which situations not, what places to work and what places not. So therefore, this is something that you really want to, talk to someone so that you can trust and know how to trust. And most importantly, be able to trust what God has placed on the inside of you, your own gauge within you, to know your, spiritual discernment, to know what he would have for you and who you should trust. One of the things that is so common with people that may have PTSD is suicidal thoughts. And this is often with those who are soldiers, who may have experienced so many different things that they wonder, why am I here? And one thing for sure, you do not want to allow anyone to get you to a low where you wind up feeling as if I need to leave this earth. There's nothing here for me. There's nothing I can contribute. These are thoughts that that have suicidal, who may have gone through these type of experiences with PTSD or PNSD, they may have suicidal thoughts. And so therefore, we do not want you to take your own life. There is help out there, and God created you for a reason. And so therefore, if you are having suicidal thoughts, I want to give you a 800 number that you can call within the U.S., 1-800-273-8255. Again, that's 1-800-273-8255. And I believe the number changed to 988 as of July 2022, 988. The National Suicide Prevention Hotline within the U.S. Within the U.K. is 0800-689-5652. In Canada, it's 1-833-456-4566. And in Australia, it's 131114. We're going to take another quick break and we'll be back in just a moment.
Well, there's a bridge and there's a river that I still must cross as I'm going on my journey. Though I might be lost, and there's a road I have to follow, a place I have to go. Well, no one told me just how to get there, but when I get there, I know, 'cause I'm taking it step by step.
And that is step by step. And that's the thing, when you are dealing with any type of abuse and you have been through that, it's step by step, day by day. It's not something that you will get over overnight. It takes time. And so you don't want to be into the blaming and saying that, you know, it was me, it was my fault. No, that's what the narcissist wants you to do. You are not in control of what someone else does. But when you begin to understand how you can prevent it and how you can stop it, then you can take control over your own life. Another thing that's a common symptom or a common sign of PTSD and PTSD is avoidance. And you might avoid certain people or even topics you're talking about it. And you may detach. And this is a normal symptom of it. However, know that you do not have to go through this alone. If you're dealing with PTSD, PTSD from somebody who was narcissistic, or let me just say this, even if you were dealing with this in the military or any type of situation that caused you to have PTSD and PTSD, whether it was war or some other things that we talked about early on, abuse, whatever the case may be, you are not alone. Talk to someone. There is help. You may deal with confusion because sometimes those that are dealing with PTSD or PTSD deal with confusion. The narcissist loves to gaslight you. They love to make you feel as if everything is your fault or is not actually happening to you. And so that is a form of psychological abuse where they try to make you doubt your reality. And narcissists love to play mental games. Don't fall for it. Know what they're about, know what they do, and try to make sure that you get the healing that you need so that you can rebuild and rebuild your self-esteem, have a sense of self-worth apart from what the narcissist did to you, because you are of value and you are worth it and your feelings do matter. Another thing, people deal with panic. You might deal with panic. You might deal with worry. You might deal with anxiety. These are things that, you know, deal with your central nervous system. And if you are experiencing this panic when you go around certain people, or you do certain things or certain, just anything triggers it, then again, you need to talk to someone who can help you navigate and find out when you're having these panic attacks, what's bringing it on, what they can narrow it down, pinpoint, and you can talk to someone who can help you walk through this so that you will not allow the effects of what happened to you control your life. If you're dealing with things, other situations, for as physical illnesses such as high blood pressure, chest pains, nausea, headaches, talk to your physician. You do not have to go through this alone. And one important thing that will help you is sometimes you gotta let go of certain people. And if you're dealing with a narcissist, some people have to go low contact because they have children that are involved, so they can't completely cut the narcissist off. Or you have to, if you don't have the children, then you can completely cut them off and go no contact with the narcissist, depending upon who it is. Even if it's at your job and you're dealing with narcissistic environment, you're dealing with a narcissistic environment, a boss, coworkers, whatever the case may be, then it may be time for you to go job hunting, pray and ask God about what job he would have you to have. And therefore, you can heal apart from that environment. Find you people that's going to be around you, people that's going to love you and care for you, and not, be supportive of the narcissist, but help you to heal, help you to know your sense of self-worth. Not that you're relying on others to give you that sense of self-worth, but people that are definitely not going to, cause it to decline. Another thing is you have to give yourself self-care. Take care of you. Whether it's going to the gym, taking your supplements, taking your medication that you're in need of, take care of you. Go spend some quality time by yourself between you and the Lord. Take care of you. you need to understand, and hopefully you do, that you are worth it. You are worth it. And when I'm talking about, you know, understanding who you are, also understanding who you are in Christ, those who are Christians, who you are in Christ, knowing that he loves us with an everlasting love and he created us. I often quote the psalmist, I am fearfully, I am wonderfully made. I know that full well. God says, I know the plans that I have for you. Okay, he told this to Israel. He knows the plans that he have for us, and those plans are for you to be all that he would have you to be. Another thing is you want to work on healing those inner wounds. I believe as a Christian that the only way we can heal is through the help of God. Take time to heal. Take time to acknowledge what you're feeling. Acknowledge what you've been through. So, because a lot of times people push it up on the rug and they allow the narcissist to diminish or even deny altogether that it took place. But once you acknowledge that these things did happen, then you got to work on healing those inner wounds, and therefore it takes time to build a trust back, to get to trust yourself again, to acknowledge that, you know, I've been in this cycle of abuse, but now I no longer want to be hurt by these type of individuals. And oftentimes that healing is going to take place along with, in my belief, for us, prayer. Okay, asking God to help, also getting counseling and having someone to help you to navigate through what you have gone through. All right, we are up out of here. I pray that today's podcast has been a blessing to you and that you will know your feelings, they do matter.
We want to thank you for taking the time to join us today on Narc Abuse No More, where we're here to help you admit what you feel in order to heal from the effects of narcissistic abuse, because your feelings do matter. Until next time.